Praveen ji, you're on mute.
व्याप्तदेहाय शुनामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्हृद्यत्तु निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमहः तदेवाहं नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यम्। जीवराज जी, प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर वीडियो। द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। सो यस्टरडे वी लुक्ड एट द मंगलाचरण। अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इन द मंगलाचरण, इफ यू नोटिस, स्टार्ट्स विद द शब्द सुखा, सुखम। इन श्रुति यू सी सच्चिदानंद सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम। आनंद शब्द इज इन द एंड। हियर यू सी द ऑथर स्टार्ट्स द प्रेयर बाय मेंशनिंग सुख स्वरूप फर्स्ट। ऑल आवर परसूट्स आर फॉर सुखा, टू अवॉइड दुखा and to gain sukha is the entire pursuit, knowingly or unknowingly. So we should not feel bad about trying to find sukha. Every being is trying to find sukha. The means are wrong. The source of sukha is misplaced. Other than that, there is nothing wrong in looking for sukha. Some acharyas mentioned that this ananda, trying to look for ananda is not right. But the ananda, swarupa ananda, cannot be avoided. What is to be avoided is the objectification of ananda, trying to look for sukha in vishaya. The search for ananda even in samadhi traps a person. But the Swarupa Ananda cannot be avoided. And it need not be avoided, because the entire pursuit is really a self-centered pursuit. If it is not selfish, it is at least self-centered. We are looking for Sukha. If someone tells you your Swarupa is Nitya and Swaprakasha, you will be Sat and Chit. Everyone knows, with a little inquiry, Sat and Chit is very easy to know. I know that I exist, and I know, because I know that I exist, I am Sat as well as Chit. We don't have trouble with Sat and Chit. What we have trouble with is Ananda. Am I really Ananda Swarupa? So Sushupti example is given to explain that our Swarupa is Ananda Swarupa even when the dream objects and waking objects were missing, still we had the Anubhava of Sukha. That has to be our own Swarupa, Swarupa Ananda, because nothing else existed then. Nothing other than me. Thereby, the Shruti also gives the example of Sushupti. People find it difficult to understand how the Sushupti had Ananda. Although they recall Ananda of a good deep sleep, still, those who have difficulty, to them, Samadhi Anubhava is prescribed. And if someone tells us in Moksha, you will remain forever, you will exist forever. People who have Samsara Dukkha, who are looking for an end of this life, not talking about suicidal particularly, but somebody who has a lot of dukkha due to disease or due to whatever reasons, physical and emotional, So with physical and emotional pain, if someone tells you that you are going to face same dukkha in moksha, who wants such kind of a moksha? Nobody really wants that kind of a moksha. Everyone is looking for the sukha in moksha. Thereby, whichever darshana talks about moksha talks about ananda as well. Without ananda, nobody wants moksha. If someone tells you will be conscious, all right, but it will be dukkha swarupa, no one will perceive it. Another reason sukha is important is because how we know it is our nature is just by searching for sukha, we know that our swarupa has to be ananda swarupa. How so? In prakriti, in loka, we see anything that changes from its very nature, that tries to go back to its nature, or whatever does not change is the nature. So if some change takes place and one is trying to go back to that particular change because one is uncomfortable. If you look at not the most appropriate example, but this always comes to mind when you look at the dog's tail. How much ever you try to straighten the dog's tail, its nature is to be bent. The dog is not comfortable if its tail is not bent. So how much you try, the tail tries to go back to the bent shape where it is happy. When you see the dog wag its tail, it is because it's happy. You see the tail is curved. And we have seen in every being, dukkha is being avoided, whether human being or non-human being. Dukkha avoidance and gaining sukha is the pursuit because that is our very nature. We feel uncomfortable when we are out of our nature. An introvert does not like to be in company. An extrovert does not like to be left alone. Thereby, whatever is one's manifest nature also, there one feels uncomfortable going away from that nature. So thereby also anyatha anupapatti, we know that otherwise one wouldn't be looking to go back to one's own swarupa, or rather one wouldn't be searching for happiness if ananda was not one's own swarupa. So it's also Siddha by Arthapatti. So Sukha is where the author starts with. Then further, all the Visheshanas being examined, in which Buddher Druk has been mentioned. Kintu Buddher Druk. What is Buddher Druk? Sarva Sakshi. Brahma Eva. Buddher Druk is at the Vyashti level, but Sarva Sakshi, at each Vyashti, the Swarupa is being a witness. Therefore, Sarva Sakshi Brahma Eva Buddhim Prakashayati. It lights up the Buddhi. It makes the thinking persona as though sentient. The sentience is not inherent in the Buddhi or the Antakarana, but by the close proximity association, by Tadatmya Sambandha, Brahmatma is lending its consciousness and we appear to be, you know, the mind appears to have gone alive. You know, so many things the mind is doing. Suddenly, we find ourselves associated with the mind and think that we are thinking so much. We have so many thoughts, but we say that I have this emotion, and that emotion becomes you as though I am sukhi, I am dukhi. I feel that I myself am happy. I am myself jealous. But the jealousy is in the mind. I know that I have jealousy. I know that I have sukha. I know that I have dukkha in the antakarana, the vritti. Therefore, I am a witness of that. So Sakshi Swarupa is mentioned by Buddhirdruk. Yan manasa namanute yen ahur mano matam tasya mahasa sarvamidam vibhati ityadi shrutibhya. So kena kathamundaka shvetashvatara upanishad talk about these mantras. They have these mantras. Yan manasa namanute, that which is never objectified by the mind, but the mind is known through which yena manaha matam ahuhu. The mind is considered to be known due to which sentience, which consciousness, that is the Atma. So you cannot objectify by the buddhi. You can know it indirectly as the implied meaning, the lakshyartha of the shabda given by the Shruti. Even there also it is lakshyartha, because it is what makes the buddhi, the mana, that cannot be objectified. Tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati. Everything, all of this, idam prapanch, idam jagat vibhati tasya bhasa. And tasya kasya, tasya mama. Once this samanadikaranyam of tat and tvam padas are understood, then tasya mama bhasa sarvam idam jagat vibhati. Ityadi shruti vya, there are so many such shruti vakyas. Buddhirna shabdasya shakti vritya brahma vijanati kintu lakshana vritya. This we have seen. The shabda vritti, shabdasya shakti vritya. The shakti vritti hidden in the shabda directly does not reveal brahma. As it is not a vachyartha. Shakti vritti is there, vachyartha it isn't. Then brahma, buddhi, katham vijanati, it is only possible through buddhi. Then how is it that buddhi does not know, and at the same time moksha is not possible without jnana, which is possible in buddhi? Why that contradiction? The contradiction is only apparent. Brahma shakti vrityana vijanati buddhi, shabdasya shakti vritya, kintu shabdasya lakshana vritya buddhihi brahma vijanati. It's possible to know, but how? By lakshana vritya. Lakshana vritya. So lakshana, the implied meaning, by, if you are doing each and every pada, tat pada and tvam pada separately, then it will be jahal lakshana. Whatever is not my swarupa, what comes and goes, agantuka, whatever comes and goes has to be dropped. So if you start dropping in each and every pada, then in the vakya it will become bhagatyaga lakshana. You drop one that is contradictory to your nature, which comes and goes, and you retain that part. One part you drop off, which is contradictory to your nature, which comes and goes, and you retain that which never goes away, that is the Sachidananda Swarupa. And same at the tatpada also, the sarvajnyatva, etc., which is contradictory to the tvampada, which is alpajnyatva. All of these contradictory attributes are dropped, and those which are not really attributes, which can never be dropped, are retained, which is that one singular Sachidananda Swarupa, that existence, the only entity which exists, which is Sat Chit and Ananda Swarupa. On both sides, it cannot be different. Therefore, there aren't two sides. There is only one. The equation Tattvamasi, when it is solved, then only one remains. There is no left-hand side and right-hand side anymore. It is only one, and that is Satchidananda. That is the Lakshana. So, Lakshana Vrutya Buddhi Brahma Vijanati. Malavikshepadi doshayukta buddhirna brahma vijanati kintu tadrahita. Also, chitta shuddhi lacking, one cannot know brahma. The buddhi, part of an antakkarana, playing the role, antakkarana playing the role of buddhi, becomes a karana, becomes a becomes an instrument to know Brahma. How? Mala vikshepadi dosha yukta buddhi brahmana vijanati. Just like the mirror which is dirty cannot reflect, similarly the buddhi which is ashuddha, antakkarana which is ashuddha, cannot play the role of buddhi which is so sharp that it can understand the subtlety of the mahavakyas. Because there is always a tainted mithya association, or rather the association with mithya anatma, which would remain cognitively also, whereby the buddhi will not be able to accept that I am the samashti with the mahavakya. Because I will always have the vyashti remaining. There will be a vestige of the vyashti which will be hanging and which won't allow me to understand the samashti vyashti aikya. Thereby, the ashuddha buddhi cannot let me know. So here buddhi na vijanati has been said. The buddhi does not help to know. Brahmana vijanati, kintu tad rahita is mala rahita. Mala vikshepadi dosha rahita. So mala vikshepadi zara dosha. Mala has been explained in the tippana. What is this mala? So mala is said to be, mala is mentioned here as further perhaps. So mala is said to be the, let me just look at the point number here. Mala vikshepa rahita. So if you look at the third point here, maya tatkarya rahita tadvan, there is a b here, this is wrong. Maya tatkarya rahitatvat nirmalam shuddham. So that mala, further he explains elsewhere in the tippana, that mala is really ajnana. Ajnana itself is the mala. And vikshepa, vikshepa is also the resultant of this mala. So you don't know the swarupa, there is an avarna of the swarupa, and then there is a vikshepa, anatma projection, where we associate. And thereby, the doshas follow, which are raga, dvesha, ityadi. So that is said here as mala vikshepadi dosha. Adipadena, you can add anything which is manifest in the antakkarana. So mala vikshepadi dosha yukta buddhihi na brahman na vijanati. So na vijanati, whereas tadrahita is mala vikshepadi dosha rahita buddhihi brahma vijanati. And further, shastracharya upadesha shamadamadi samskrutam mana atma darshane karanam. This is a typo here. It is not karanam, karanam. Iti Gita Bhashya Vachanat. So under Gita, Bhagavan Bhashyakara writes this as Shastracharya Upadesha Shamadamadi Samskrutam. The Shamadamadi Shatka helps the Antakkarana to be Samskruta, Samyakruta, Shuddha, Shuddhi Kruta. So shuddhi krutam manaha, that manaha atma darshane karanam, it becomes an instrument in the vision of the self. What is the vision? It is the right cognition of the self as not associated with any of the kosha, but kosha rahita shuddha sachidananda brahma, that is the atma swarupa. And that is possible only when shastra acharya upadesha Shamadamadi Samskruta, but not Shamadi, Shamadamadi Samskruta mana alone, but that kind of a mind, the Antakkarana Manaha, where the Buddhi, when it starts playing the role of the Buddhi, then it understands what is taught by the Shastra and the Acharya. So Shastra and Acharya can be seen in two ways, Shastra and Acharya, but the teaching isn't different, therefore Shastra taught by an Acharya. Both ways samasas are possible. That kind of a manaha or buddhi becomes karana towards atma darshana. Iti Gita Bhashya Vachanat. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that there to explain as to resolving the apparent contradiction between the mind cannot know versus mind alone can help you know, or buddhi cannot help you objectify but buddhi alone can help you understand by lakshana vritti. Aso buddhirapi phalavyaptya na brahma vijaniyat kintu vritti vyaptya eva. So in the prakriya of Vedanta as to how any indriya functions, how do we know anything, ghatapatadi or brahma? So when we know ghatapatadi, the jagat, any vishaya in the prapancha, then what happens is the antakarana goes out with the indriya, because the vishayas drag the indriyas, and through the golakas, tattat golaka, whichever golaka is responsible for that vishaya. What vishaya? It is the object in the form of the guna. We cannot objectify the object as known in science. Or if we say subject-object division, the object is not the entire vastu which is there outside. Vastu as in the laukika sense vastu. But we see the, we cognize the guna. So shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, those are the vishayas. Thereby, when ghata is objectified, ghata is seen, then the chakshurindriya is responsible for the sight. So chakshurindriya is drawn towards the ghata and it drags along the antakkarana. Then when there is a covering, this antakkarana covers via the chakshurindriya, it covers in the sense takes the akara of the ghata. So we say there is a ghatakara vritti. That ghatakara vritti, how do I know the ghata when there is a ghatakara vritti? In the antakkarana there is a ghata reflection, and that ghata reflection, so to say reflection, it is not actually a reflection in the sense of, for a lack of better word, we say reflection, the akara. So it can be shabdakara, it can be rupakara, rasakara. Any akara is not the form in the sense of shape. Form is this form of sound, the form of rasa ityadi. And when that takes place, then it takes away the particular vishaya ajnana, tola ajnana. So that particular vishaya ajnana is taken away by this jnana vritti, ghata jnana. How ghata? Akara vritti takes away the ghata jnana, then the veil is removed. But how do we know that it is a ghata? What happens is that the ghata does not have its own prakasha. So it has to be lit up. The chaitanya underlying the antakkarana and the chaitanya underlying the ghata is same. When that chaitanya lights up, the chaitanya of the seer, of the drashta, lights up the which is in the antakkarana. Antakkarana substratum is chaitanya swarupa that lights up the vritti, ghatakara vritti. Then this consciousness underlying the ghata and the antakkarana being one, I say ghatam aham janami, I know the ghata. And this is true for each and every shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha. This ghata aham janami is the rupa example, which is commonly used because rupa is more than 50% of the input. That is why we close our eyes when we focus on something, or when we have to focus on something, we close our mind, close our eyes, cut off the rupa input, because it is quite strong. And this is an example used to explain everything else. This is an upalakshana, only rupa is explained, but such is the case of each and every vishaya, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Now, what happens in the case of brahmakara vritti, when there is a vritti which is taking place, the inquiry, contemplation, manana is going on, and then it becomes ekadhara, like nididhyasana, of similar thoughts. What are the similar thoughts? That help us conclude and analyze and land on the Mahavakya. Mahavakya conclusion. So that Mahavakya तत्त्वमसि और अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि, दैट महावाक्य व्हेन इट इज बीइंग एनालाइज्ड, देन वंस इट इज अंडरस्टूड दैट देर आर नो टू एंटिटीज, देर इज ओनली वन, देन देर इज अ ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति. दिस आकार इज अगेन नॉट अ फॉर्म, इट इज ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति, सच्चिदानंद आकार ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति. दैट ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति टेक्स अवे दी अज्ञान ऑफ माई ओन स्वरूप, स्वरूप अज्ञान इट टेक्स अवे. वंस इट टेक्स अवे, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वृत्ति व्याप्ति, विच इज सेम एज दी वृत्ति व्याप्ति इन दी घटाकार, घटाकार वृत्ति. व्हेन आई से घटम अहम जानामि, दैट टाइम दी घट अज्ञान इज टेकन अवे बाय दी घट वृत्ति, बिकॉज देर इज अ कवरिंग ऑफ दी घटाकार, घटाकार that takes place in my antakarana, ghatakara vritti, that takes away the ghata jnana, and that what takes away is actually the vritti vyapti, the covering or the akara of the antakarana in the form or in keeping with the shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha. In the ghata example, the rupa, when it takes that akara, it takes away the ghata jnana. That taking the akara of the vishaya is called as the vritti vyapti. So vritti vyapti is same here also, because you have a brahmakara vritti. That brahmakara vritti is vritti vyapti, it takes away the brahma ajnana. Once it takes away the ajnana, in comparison to the ghatakara vritti, where the underlying ghata did not have its own prakasha, here brahma has its own prakasha, therefore it does not need to be lit up. That lighting up or showing this is the ghata, lighting up the vritti, this is the ghatakara vritti, that lighting up is called as phalavyapti. Here you don't need phalavyapti, therefore it is said aso buddhirapi phalavyapta vyaptya brahmana vijanati vijaniyat na brahma vijaniyat, is it does not know, it wouldn't know with through phalavyapti. Phalavyapti is not necessary, it is not needed, because it is swaprakasha rupa, which is me, and thereby I cannot objectify myself, I need not objectify myself. Kintu vritti vyapta eva, there is only vritti vyapti, but there is no phala vyapti. Iyancha vrittir dipo yatha swasambaddha padarthan prakashayati na tatha brahma prakashayatum prabhavati. And this vritti yatha deepaha yatha swasambaddha padarthan prakashayati, just like a lamp lights up its own those which are gochara, those are in the, which are in the field of the light of the lamp, that lamp shows up the objects which fall in the range of the light of the lamp. Na tatha brahma prakashayatum prabhavati vritti, vritti cannot light up the brahma in the same manner. Kintu andakare ghatadyavruta रत्न प्रदीपादिर यथा घटादि स्वावरणे सावरण भंगे स्वयमेव प्रकाशते एवं अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि इति प्रमाणजन्य प्रमारूप वृत्ति ब्रह्माकार ब्रह्मावरक अज्ञान नाश मात्रं करोति. सो एग्जांपल इज गिवन, व्हाट शुड इट बी कंपेयर्ड विद, दिस अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ब्रह्म इज नॉट लाइक दि फलव्याप्ति इज एक्सप्लेन्ड हियर. How you see the ghata, let's say ghata is lit up by the deepa, by a lamp, then how the lamp lights it up, similarly Brahma cannot be lit up, because Brahma is the subject, is the very content of the subject. So it is not an object separate which can be lit up. Then what is the example? The example given is that, let's say there is darkness, and in darkness andhakare ghatadi avruta ratna pradipadi yatha, and the ratna, let's say there is a shining gem, that gem, shining gem, or we can take an example of a pradipa, it's a ratna pradipadi, so anything that has its own shine, at the laukika level it has its own shine. You keep a shining object such as pradipa, a lamp, and that lamp is covered with a ghata, it is covered with a pot, there is pitch darkness around. Now this, due to this darkness, यू कैनॉट सी वॉट इज हिडन, यू कैन बेयरली सी दी घटा. नाउ वेन यू लिफ्ट अप दैट घटा, मे बी यू कैनॉट सी इट, बट देन यू नो दैट देर इज अ घटा देर एंड यू लिफ्ट दैट घटा अप. दैट टाइम द वे द लैम्प शाइन्स ऑन इट्स ओन विच इज हिडन, विच वॉज नॉट apparent to us, which was not known to us, that the we say that there is pitch darkness, but there is actually a lamp, or there is some swaprakasha vastu there within, hidden. Once you lift that, you don't need another light to light it up, because it is swaprakasha. Similarly is the aham brahmasmi. Evam aham brahmasmi iti pramana janya pramarupa vrittihi, the pramarupa vritti, which is valid, that knowledge which takes place through the means of knowledge. Which are the means of knowledge? This Shastracharya Upadesha, which is actually the Shruti. Shruti is the Pramana there. So Pramana Janya, Shruti Pramana Janya, Pramarupa Vritti, that Vritti Brahma Avaraka Ajnana, that Ajnana which is veiling the Brahma. Brahma is my own Swarupa. That अज्ञान नाश मात्रं करोति, इट जस्ट डिस्ट्रॉयज द अज्ञान, जस्ट लाइक टेकिंग अवे और लिफ्टिंग द पॉट विच इज कवरिंग द लैम्प. सिमिलरली इफ वन लिफ्ट्स द वेल विच इज कवरिंग वन सोन स्वरूप थ्रू दिस प्रमाणजन्य प्रमा, देन दैट वृत्ति, इफ द वृत्ति टेक्स इट अवे, देन यू डोंट नीड अ फलव्याप्ति. You don't need anyone to show you that lamp. Similarly, you don't need anyone to show you anything else to light up your own swarupa. Brahma tu buddhyadi sadhanantara nirapeksham eva swasambaddha sarvabhasakatva rupa swayam jyotishtvena nityaparoksha rupatvat swayam pratate. It shines forth on its own. It reveals its own nature and it is no longer it. For a lack of better word, we say it, because Brahma is something else, initially thought of as something else, at least in the Vakya analysis. In the Aham Brahmasmi, Aham is sitting as a separate pada. Brahma is a separate pada. Once we understand this Asmi, Asi, or Asi pada in the Tattvamasi Vakya, here Asmi, Asmi pada is understood as showing the samanadikaranam between aham and brahma. How so? If once that is understood, the kosha rahita, pancha kosha rahita aham is same as the samashti brahma, which is bereft of its roles or the other upadhis. All the upadhi at the samashti is taken away, at the vyashti aham the upadhis are taken away. What remains is the upadhi rahita sachidananda aham and upadhi rahita sachidananda brahma, which is one sachidananda. There cannot be two. Thereby anantyam is not compromised, purnatvam is not compromised, as revealed by the shruti. So when it is pramana janya, this aham brahmasmi is understood, then that aham brahmasmi vritti takes away. Aham Brahmasmi iti pramana janya pramarupa vritti, that aham brahmasmi is a vritti there, and it becomes brahmakara vritti, and that takes away brahma avaraka ajnana, nashamatram karoti, it takes away the, destroys the ajnana which is veiling my own swarupa. Therefore brahma shines forth, brahma tu swayam pratate. In short, how buddhyadi sadhanantara nirapeksham eva, without expecting anything else other than this buddhyadi sadhanantara, nothing else is needed. This only buddhi ityadi is needed. Buddhi is basically the sadhana chatushte sampanna chitta shuddhi. The chitta shuddhi which is attained through the sadhana chatushtaya by the seeker. He attains chitta shuddhi and then expecting nothing else, nirapeksham, you expect nothing else. The buddhi also is no longer in play, because this buddhi was a sadhana only for the vritti to come up. Once this vritti has come up, it helped us understand the pramana. once the pramana is understood, once aham brahmasmi is understood, then there is no other sadhana also needed. Swasambaddha sarvaubhasakatva roopa, the brahma which has made buddhyadi sadhana also work as sadhanas, does not depend on the sadhana at all, never was dependent, but it was helpful only to take away the avarana on oneself, that one's own swarupa, which is now without any avarana, which helped the sadhana also to take away one's avarana. Once that avarana is gone, no instrument is needed. Swasambaddha sarvabhasakatva. Sarvabhasakatva rupa swayam jyoti. That swayam jyoti rupa atma, brahmatma, which helped the others work to remove one's own avarana, then being in that form, swayam jyotishtvena nitya aparoksha. Nitya aparoksha rupatvat swayam pratate. Because it was never paroksha at all. The jnana felt paroksha, but the chit, which is hidden in that jnana, in the karaka rupa jnana, all the karaka rupa jnana, the chit which is without any karaka artha, which is not even the shuddha dhatu artha, which is understood by Lakshana even through the Shuddha Dhatu Artha, because the Jnana Dhatu is Sakarmaka Dhatu, dropping that Sakarmakattvam also, the Jnana which is helping get us Jnana, that Jnana Dhatu has its Swarupa hidden within, which is Chaitanya or Chit. So Jnana also Pada, Jnana Pada, when analyzed, all karakas are dropped, then all the pratyas which are leading to that jnana, the lyud pratya, those who have studied vyakarana, their jnana dhatu, which is said to be sakarmaka, that also drops off. Bhagavan Bhashyakara analyzes in satyam jnanam anantam mahavakya, not mahavakya, satyam jnanam anantam as the swarupa lakshana, which is the swarupa lakshana definition, satyam jnanam anantam brahma. Under that mantra, Bhagavan Bhashyakara analyzes, and finally, although he says it is Shuddha Dhatu Artha, he further says that he takes a Purva Paksha, and without agreeing with the Purva Paksha, he agrees that it is not the Shuddha Dhatu Artha also, it can be known only through Lakshana. And knowing through Lakshana is what? The Chit Swarupa. Jnanai Chitswarupa, Jnadhatu is also really landing you in Chitswarupa of your own self. So Nitya Aparoksha Rupatvat, it was never Paroksha. The misunderstanding was that it is Paroksha, but it is Nitya Aparoksha. It is that without which there is nothing else. Without Aham coming up, without the Aham, you cannot have Idam Pratyaya, you cannot have Idam Vritti, without the aham vritti. So sitting within the aham vritti, without the I am this or that, just that I am, without qualifying it as anything, that anantyam is not compromised. It is always there, even when it is associated with the koshas, it is not really limited. It is never paroksha. So nitya aparoksha rupatva swayam prathate, the brahma shines forth, therefore no phalavyapti is needed. That is another way to see that why buddhir druk, but buddhi na janati punascha tad brahma katham bhutam. There is another what other visheshana is there for that brahma which is me. Nirvalam says, Sadhu says, Nirmalam. Nirmalam is Shuddham. Nirmala is Shuddham, and this Nirmala we saw in the Tippana also. Aparam. Aparam is Desha Kala Vastu Aparachinnam Chabhavati. Aparam is, yesterday I mentioned as that, without a para, without a shore, it is that Purnatva. How do you get Purnatva? Purnatva when not compromised by Desha Kala or Vastu. It will not become parichinna, then it will remain purna. So aparam पूर्णत्वम इज एक्सप्लेन्ड एज देश काल वस्तु अपरिच्छिन्न नेवर सेगमेंटेड इन देश. वॉट इज देश परिच्छिन्नत्व? देश परिच्छिन्नत्व इज इफ इफ आई एम हियर आई से इफ घटा लेट से इफ घटा इज हियर दैट घटा कैनॉट बी एल्सवेयर दैट इज इट इज लिमिटेड इन स्पेस लिमिटेड इन प्लेस इट इज देश परिच्छिन्न. If the ghata exists today, it cannot remain forever. The ghata will go away in time. It will wither away in time. There is wear and tear. So that is kala parichinna, limited in kala, in time. Vastu parichinna is ghata cannot be pata. Being ghata itself means that it is not a pata. So it is vastu parichinna also. It is limited as a thing. Being a thing, it is limited. By being only that thing, not being anything else. But Brahma is not limited in Desha, not limited in Kala, not limited as Vastu also, because nothing exists other than it itself. So it is Vyapaka, thereby it is available everywhere, all at once. Kalasyapi Kalaha, that Brahma aparichinnam cha bhavati. Atha visheshananam pratyekam prayojanam uchyate. Now, why so many visheshanas have been mentioned? So each of these are analyzed. Sukham, Nityam. Sukham and Nityam are taken as a pair. Sukha would have sufficed. Why Nitya has been mentioned? Sukhasya Nityatva Visheshananupadane Vaishayike Samaye Sukhe. Vaishayike Samaye Sukhe. The Vaishayika Sukha is what? Amayena sa vartate iti samaya. It is samayam because the vaishayika sukha, vishaya sukha is along with its own flaws, along with its dukkha. It is dukkha mishrita. Therefore, it is samaya sukha. Samaya sukhe, vaishayike samaya sukhe, sukhasya nityatva visheshana anupadane. If nitya had not been mentioned, then just sukha is your sarupa. Brahma Swarupa, Atma Swarupa, then Ananda Rupa, what Ananda? There is also Vishaya Ananda. Vishaya Sukha is there. So is this Sukha like Vishaya Sukha? No. Vishaya Sukha is Dukkha Mishrita. Dukkha Mishrita and what else? It is Anitya Nayayika Abhimate Atma Gune Anandecha Ativyaptihi. So there will be Ativyaptihi because Atma Guna is considered as Ananda in Nayayika Mata. Nyaya Mata, Nyaya considers all the gunas as Atma, being in Atma. We do not agree with it, but they will say when you are discussing with a Nayayika, he'll say that this Sukha is the Atma Guna. Then Sukha is not Atma Guna. This Sukha, which Sukha? He is talking about the Sukha. The Nayayika says whichever Sukha Anubhava takes place, all the Guna, Sukha as a Guna is there in the Atma Gune Anande Cha Adivyapti. That kind of Ananda, which is the Guna of the Atma, is not this Sukha, which is the Swarupa Sukha. Swarupa Sukha is not that. Nayayika's Ananda is not what is mentioned by Sukha, because it is Anitya. Nayayika Sukha is Anitya. But if Nityam Pada had not been said, then there would be Ativyapti there. Ativyapti means the Ananda Lakshana, as a Lakshana definition of one's own Swarupa as Sukha or Brahma as Sukha, would apply to the Ananda of the Atma Guna of Nyaya, in the Nyaya Darshana also. So the Lakshana will be overreaching. It is not limited to Brahma anymore. It goes to the individualized Atma of the Nayayika also, which has the Sukha as its own Guna. So that Sukha we are not talking about. We are not talking about the Vaishayika Sukha. Therefore, to Tadupadane, Tadupadane is Nitya, Nitya Pada Upadane. That Nityam has been added because Nitya Upadane, when you add that Sukham Nityam, then तदुपादाने तु विषयानंदस्य आत्मगुणस्य च आनंदस्य अनित्यत्व प्रसिद्धेः नाति व्याप्तिः. सो द विषयानंद विच इज टॉक्ड अबाउट और द विषयानंद विच इज द which leads to the ananda as a swarupa of an individual atma, not swarupa there, guna. In Nyayamata, atma guna. So atma guna and vishaya ananda, ananda as atma guna or ananda as being there in the vishaya, vishaya ananda. Vishaya ananda and atma guna ananda of nyaya are excluded in the definition by saying that sukham nityam. So tadupadane tu vishayanandasya atmagunasya cha anandasya anityatva prasiddhehe. This in there is sukha, sukham aham anubhavami. That is the atmaguna of nayayika. Nyaya, nyayashastra, nayayika would say, in nyayashastra, nyayayika would say, I have anubhava. If I have anubhava sukha, then sukha is my guna. This is how the logician would argue. And Vishayananda is there. There is Vishayananda. And whenever there is Vishayananda, in the Vishaya there is Ananda. This is a misunderstanding. In the Sukha being the Guna of Atma is a misunderstanding. It is not only Sukha. Every Dukkha Mahamanubhavi, he will say Dukkha is the Atma Guna. Vishayananda, Vishaya Dukkha also is there. We want to avoid a particular Vishaya. So there is a misunderstanding as to where the Ananda is. Is it is in the Vishaya, they think, many of the people think that there is Vishayananda. Even the person who has Jnana, a Jnani Matra, goes after Vishaya because there is Purva Vasana. That Vasana makes one go after, hanker after Vishaya, looking for Ananda. So Vishayanandasya Atmagunasya cha Anandasya Anityatva Prasiddhe. Vishaya Sukha does not stay forever. Everyone knows that Vishaya Sukha is not long lasting, therefore they want to have ananda again and again. That same Vishayananda, I want the same Vishayananda, it manifests ananda in me. Then the Atma Guna also, when I experience a particular Vishaya, I get Sukha, that Sukamaham Anubhavami, that is Atma Guna says a Nayayika, that also does not stay. When the Vishaya is taken away, Dukkha comes back again. So Atma Guna Sukha goes away, it is Agantuka. Vishayananda is Agantuka, Atma Guna is Agantuka, meaning Agantuka means comes and goes. It is not Nitya. Therefore, Anityatva Prasiddhe, it is well known as Anitya. Therefore, Na Ati Vyapti. There the Lakshana does not overreach. It remains with the Atma. So, therefore, the first pair is shown. The other pairs will also be analyzed moving further. This Mangalacharana is analyzed quite a lot because it is the Tattva here. There is a Tattva, Tattva Rupa Mangalacharana. We have seen that Tattva. Nirdesha Rupa, Vastu Nirdesha Rupa Mangalacharana, therefore the it has a lot of content. And since it has a lot of content of Vedanta, it is analyzed a lot, and with Tarka also it is analyzed as to why so many Visheshanas have been added by the author in Mangalacharana. We'll stop here, we'll continue in the next Patha. Tomorrow there will be no Patha, being Guruvara. We'll continue on Friday. सुखम नित्यम सत्प्रकाशम व्यापकम नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानम बुद्ध्यबोध्यम बुद्धेर्दृग्यत्व निर्मलम अपारम सर्वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्यक् परम महः तदेवाहम नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चितामतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस? I'll see in the next part. Namaste.
हरि ओम.
हरि ओम.